Welcome to another presentation about Microsoft Visio. My name is Chanel Illich and I'm the worldwide VTSP for Visio. In this presentation, I'd like to show you how to create rich org charts within Microsoft Visio, the Microsoft Visio universe. Now, I will focus on both Visio platform environments. One is Visio Desktop, one is Visio for the web, which for you might be featured by Microsoft Visio Plan 1 or Visio and Microsoft 365. So let's start with the web experience. In this case, I have opened the starting page of my Visio for the web. And as you see, by default, unless you use it very often, the org charts are not in here. So let's hit more templates. And then you have a specific org chart category. Now there is a very nice feature that has been added to Visio for the web. And as you see here, when I move my mouse, I see create blank or explore more. So in some cases you have predefined pre-populated diagrams, which you can just open and then extend or modify to your needs. But we'll start with the create blank. And in this case, Visio opens the drawing environment with specific org chart shapes. So we see here the executive shape, the manager shape, the assistant shape, vacancy, and all the other positions. Now, we also have some different styles and designs made available for you. So as you see, depending on the stencil you open, your org chart shapes look slightly different. So it's very easy, depending on how much data you want to add, to pick the right stencil for your specific need, for your specific environment. How do you work then with them? Well, the rest is rather standard Visio. So you place your shape, and as you see, when I move my mouse over it, I get these little arrows. So I either click on one of them, or I just move my connector to one specific other element, or I click on it here, and then you see a specific shape is added and connected to you. This is a very nice extension which will help you to not have to drag and drop and move all the way around. So the same goes here. If I click on and just hold with the mouse, I can specifically have a specific shape added to the environment. Keep in mind that depends, of course, on the stencil which is right now open. So if I change the stencil, you see that another shape is added to the autocomplete list. So this is how Visio for the web looks like. Now let's look in Visio Desktop. And for this, I will open Visio Desktop. I will go to the File New or Home tab and pick File New. And there you will find the org charts, usually either by going to the Templates category, it's in the Business category, or here in the Office category, just by browsing a bit. They're usually, depending on how you use Visio in there, otherwise go again to the Business category, and that's where you will find the org charts too. So let's go here to the Business category and hit org chart. As always, Visio allows you to start with a pre-populated, pre-created diagram, or to start from scratch. Let's start from scratch here. And the first thing Visio asks me is, do you want to start with information which you already have in a file? In this case, I don't want to do that, but you could provide Visio a file or a database where the data is coming from. By the way, the data could come from a text file, Org Plus, Excel, Exchange Server, or any other ODBC compliant database. But in this case, I will just hit cancel to show you what's in the background working for you. So I just drop the executive belt. And now usually you have to drop the shape, format the shape, place the shape, connect, etc. In Visio Desktop, the only thing you have to do is drop the shape above the other, and Visio will take care of placing them, connecting them, and finding the best layout. By the way, the same works for the assistant. Watch what happens. You see, Visio moves the shapes down so the assistant can fit in between the executive and the managers. And there we also have some staff belts where with one shape, you can add several other options. So if we have, for example, the multiple shapes here, you see that we can pick how many shapes of which type are being added, and then Visio will do that for you. Now, As always, here we have shape data, so metadata. So let's go either to the org chart tab, or we go to the data tab, open the shape data window here, and then you will see that the data is added here. So I could add the name here. And you see that immediately this value is updated. I could also say the title. And then the information is updated. Now on the org chart tab, you will be able to configure how and where which information is stored. So you could also have the data changed or have the objects changed. You can change elements, or you can even have Visio insert pictures into your org chart. The way you do this is you provide Visio a folder which contains the pictures of the employees, and the picture file name is the name of the employee, and Visio will do automatically the specific import. So it's very easy. And then of course you have different things like changing the height, changing position type. You also have the ability here to change the general design just simply by clicking. And then you see what different designs Visio is offering. So this is all something which makes working very easy. And something people miss is if you click on this little button here, you get into the options dialog, which allows you to define the shapes in width and height to the millimeter, and you can define which fields, which shape data fields are shown in which element or which block, where block one is the bigger one and block two is the smaller one. So this is something you can always configure. I hope you found this presentation informative and it gave you a few new ideas on how to use Visio. Thank you very much and have a great day.